Hey, what up, my friend? This is Sergio Felix from marketingwithsergio.com, and I want to share three things that I learned this week for you, and I think that it's going to be like really interesting if you are in the internet marketing niche. The first one is soft launching an ebook on Kindle or on Amazon, the marketplace. The idea is that you get together something that it's called like a street team or something like that, and it only translates to having a bunch of people that are really, really fans of your work. So as soon as you launch your book, people will, you know, download it, purchase it, read it, and leave a review for it. And the idea is that as you get more reviews, the book starts to get more momentum, and you get, well, more sales and more reviews, and you get a better ranking inside the Amazon marketplace. And that's how you actually get the bestseller status, or one of the things that you have to do in order to get that. Well, the idea is that what happened to me? I just launched a book this past week. It's called the 7-Day Internet Marketing Plan, and the idea is that it shows you how to, well, put a business online in just 7 days. It's basically aimed at newbies or like people that do not know how to, well, register a domain name or purchase a hosting, link both things, how to install WordPress and stuff like that. And the idea is that it narrates all the mistakes that I did when I was just getting started with internet marketing, which I did like a ton, okay? I lost count about all the fuck-ups that I did when I was just getting started. I still messed from time to time, but I think I messed a lot less than I was doing in the beginning. So anyway, the soft launching an ebook, highly recommended if you just want to get things done. Not recommended at all if you actually want to do it the right way. The right way is you should have a list of subscribers that are aware that you are launching an ebook, and a bunch of people like your friends, your social media followers, fans. You have to do like videos. I mean, that's what I will do. But here's the thing. I was not going to launch my ebook in that way. I was actually not going to do a major launch either. But what I wanted to do is have a base of fans, followers, subscribers, knowing that there was this book coming up and will buzz around it. And the idea is that I was dabbling with some settings inside the Amazon marketplace, and I think I just crossed a line where you couldn't get back anymore. You know, I was like, yeah, it's Sergio Felix, the author, and these are the keywords, and this is, you know, like the description of the book and stuff like that. And my wife was telling me, you know, you have been doing that for months. Why don't you launch that thing already and see what happens? And she was like that all these past months. But I wasn't going to launch yet. I was going to put a landing page. I was going to do promoted ads to it. And I was going to do a lot more things. And all of a sudden, I got this message inside Amazon that said, congratulations, your book is sent for review process or something like that. And I was like, what the fuck? I think I just sent my book already. So I couldn't just know, I didn't know how to pause this. I was like, you know, screw it. I'm just going to let it go, and I'm just going to see what happens, you know? And that's what happened. The idea is that the launch sold probably like 15 units at most and generated like $4 or $5. I'm not sure. The book it's at 99 cents. I was seeing the rankings in the first days, but hear me out. When I was doing this, I was going on a vacation trip the next day, so I couldn't do, you know, anything at all. Even there's a strategy for Kindle books or Kindle authors where you put a link inside the first pages of your book, so you get to well, get to siphon the traffic that you get from people that click on the book cover of your book and just want to get to know how you write and get a feeling if they're going to like your book or not. Well, you can actually do something with that traffic. So I the landing page wasn't ready. I didn't have anything ready, anything of that. So the book was launched and it was a total flop. I consider it a flop. A lot of people will probably believe that it was a major hit. I don't know, but that's how I feel it inside. You know, I was hoping not for bestseller status. Actually, that's something that took a lot of time in my mind in the past month until I just said, you know what, I don't want to be a bestseller. If it happens, it happens. And if it doesn't, I don't care. I just want to launch my book already. So anyway, that's what happened when you launch, or when I did launch my ebook with this soft kind of launch, all right? So take that into consideration. If you already have a book in the back burner and you just want to let it go or to release it, you can do it, but you may not get, you know, like bestseller status or this. You are going to get you are a published author right now, a formal published author. And for me, that was enough, but I wanted to get a little bit more. Right now, the book has zero reviews and well, the sales just flopped. And so that's what happens. I actually have a few more books that I want to finish and get done. So I'm just going to focus on that and probably I'm going to relaunch the book anyway. So that was about launching or soft launching an ebook. I'm actually going to be talking a little bit faster because I don't want this video to be like really, really, really long, and it's already long. I'm not sure how much I've been recording for. 7 minutes, that's a lot. But anyway, outsourcing jobs to friends, don't do it. I have a few friends, or not a few, I have a ton of friends that are really, really experts at what they do. And that means graphic designers, web developers, front-end web developers, database experts, video experts, video editing experts, and expert photographers. And the idea is that every single time I try to outsource a job to a friend of mine, something has happened, and not in a positive way. The side or the negative side of this is that this is people that you care about. It's friends, close friends with you. It's not the same when you are just hiring someone for their expertise and they are just not, you know, getting the job done. Then you get to, you know what, you know, to get to fire them. And it's not the same thing when you are, you know, doing this with friends. So I don't actually recommend you do it. If you have managed to do this and do it with a positive outcome, well, you probably should talk to me and let me know how you are doing it. But it's not been working for me. I have a few works yet that I have to receive from friends, but I'm not going to be like hiring any more people apart from these jobs that I already sent for them. All right, so that's there's that. And the other thing is vacations with a toddler or with a baby. I have a 9-month-old baby called Nina, and while she is lovely and stuff, she does not let me do anything at all. I mean, she's always like yelling, and she actually behaves right, but she's like really loud and manages to get a ton of my attention when my wife obviously wants to get a shower or cook or something. I have to look after the baby, and there's really, really short spans of time when I'm actually in the house and I want to get some, you know, some work done, and that's when I actually have to watch the baby. So it's really challenging to get jobs done or to get things done when having a baby. So why do I say this? This is not a rant and this is not a complaint. I want to clarify that. That's actually her. I'm not sure if she comes through the mic, but the idea is that before the baby, I had another kind of barriers, like the neighbor has really loud parrots that, you know, drive me crazy all the time. Then the neighbor is really loud, and there's a ton of different things that got in the way. And I'm just going to say this, just work with whatever you have and just get it done. Just get it done. Right, like I just soft launched that ebook. I don't care. I can just focus on the next thing. I don't care about it. It's launched. Whoever wants to purchase it, it is there. It's not occupying any more time in my brain, you know? The same thing it's with whatever you want to get done with internet marketing. I was really afraid of doing videos in the beginning. And as soon as I started, you know, to get the hang out of doing videos, I started to purchasing like really more equipment. Like I got a Rebel T3i. In that time, it was like a really good camera. Right now, it's not the best camera ever. But I had that DSLR camera, and then I have these light boxes, and I got the green screen, the white screen, the black screen. I got the microphones, I got a ton of equipment, and the idea is that you normally don't have that much time to get everything done. If you don't have a baby, if you don't have dogs, if you are actually living by yourself, if you actually have a quiet place, then you probably can get a ton out of having all that gear and have a studio that you don't have to mount and unmount every single time that you want to record things and you just want to get everything done and, you know, put away everything. So if you have like a studio, well, good for you. But for those that don't have a studio and that have pets and that have a lot of loud noises in their environment, or probably a toddler or even sons and kids or jumping and running around, you're probably not going to need any of these fancy cameras or light boxes or anything like that at all. I have seen a lot of people doing a ton of their internet marketing with just their cell phones, and basically that's it. Just a cell phone and a shitty tripod for the cell phone. Some of them actually still are holding the cell phone. And these are really, really big marketers. I'm telling you, I'm not going to give you any names, but I'm talking top dogs in the internet marketing niche. So you probably don't need to do all of that. And the reason I'm telling you this is because I have seen it. I have lived through it myself. And honestly, you don't need all of that to actually get things done. Right now, I'm shooting with a Meteor microphone, which Michael Neal gifted me. Thank you for that. I'm still using it. I'm shooting with a really old Logitech camera. I think this is the C910. And as you can see, I have no backdrop. And it sucks, the lighting, it sucks everything, but you are still watching this video and it's really too long. So that proves my point. All right. So anyway, thank you for watching and sorry for making this long ass video, but I just wanted to tell you, this is really important about soft launching an ebook, working your way out with internet marketing and with having a toddler, a dog, a pet, whatever, and outsourcing micro jobs to friends. Don't do it unless you already got it going and it's working out for you. All right. So thank you for watching. This was Sergio Felix, and I hope that you have a fantastic start of week. Next day, it's April 24th. All right. So take care and bye-bye.